Good afternoon. Breaking at 4 p.m, former Jetstar pilot Greg Lynn has been sentenced to 32 years behind bars for the killing of missing camper Carol Clay, described as violent, brutal and horrific by the judge today. A jury in June found the 58-year-old guilty of shooting Ms. Clay at a campsite in the Victorian High Country in March 2020, but acquitted him over the death of her lover, Russell Hill. He will be eligible for parole in 2048 and ahead of reaction from the family of Carol Clay. A major police manhunt is underway after three hooded men allegedly shot a man in Sydney Olympic Park multiple times and set a getaway car on fire. Residents in the area rattled by what unfolded.
It sounded like whips. They were ricocheting off these walls. About five or six shots. Then I heard the gate get smashed in, and three guys all in black with hoodies run to this vehicle.
Erin Ramsey will have more details for us a little later in the bulletin. Cost concerns over the AUKUS pact have been raised in a new report that outlines an alternative plan for the multi-billion dollar security deal. Politics reporter Claudia Radoljak has more from Canberra. Claudia, good afternoon. What's the government had to say?
Good afternoon, Sophie. Well, the government says it's still committed to the current AUKUS plan, which involves Australia purchasing American nuclear submarines and is estimated to cost up to $368 billion. But this latest research warns the price could break Australia's military budget and capabilities in deterring China. It suggests America maintains ownership of the subs, but that Australia operates them and instead spends funding on long-range anti-ship missiles, drones and bombers. Cost concerns have also been raised today in a parliamentary hearing which is examining the AUKUS pact. Earlier, environmental groups told the committee they want to see an independent inquiry investigating whether it's in our national interest. Sophie.
Claudia, with that update, thank you. Well, further distress surrounding the death of One Direction star Liam Payne today, with the release of the emergency call made by hotel staff in the lead-up to his balcony fall. It emerged as former bandmate Harry Styles paid tribute to his friend, in part writing, "I am truly devastated by Liam's passing. His greatest joy was making other people happy, and it was an honour to be alongside him as he did. I will miss him always, my lovely friend. My heart breaks for Karen, Jeff, Nicola and Ruth, his son Bear, and all those around the world who knew and loved him as I did." Those remarks following a joint tribute from his bandmates as more details emerge about the moments leading up to his death. Here's Europe correspondent Jessica Millwood.
Well, the statement from the other One Direction bandmates is heartbreaking and would have no doubt been very difficult for the boys to write. It in part reads, "We're completely devastated by the news of Liam's passing. In time and when everyone is able to, there will be more to say. But for now, we will take time to grieve and process the loss of our brother, who we loved dearly." They sign off, "We will miss him terribly. We love you, Liam, Louis, Zane, Niall and Harry." In a separate statement on Instagram, Louis has written a very lengthy piece in dedication to Liam. "I wish I got the chance to say goodbye and tell you one more time how much I loved you. Payne, my boy, one of my best friends, my brother, I love you, mate. Sleep well." One Direction formed here in the UK in 2010 after auditioning for The X Factor. They had extremely dedicated fans, and that endures today, with many of them holding vigil outside the Buenos Aires Hotel where Liam Payne fell to his death. An emergency call made by a hotel manager just before he fell has been released.
Bueno, tenemos un huésped que está sobrepasado de droga y alcohol, y cuando está consciente, está rompiendo toda la habitación. Yo no sé si corre riesgo la vida del huésped. Está en una habitación que tiene balcón, y bueno, estamos un poco con temor de que haga algo.
Argentinian media have also obtained images from inside the hotel room. It shows drugs, alcohol, and a lot of damage. Liam Payne's family are on their way to Argentina. They've also released a statement saying they are absolutely heartbroken, while fans in the UK say they are supporting each other through this difficult time.
It's okay to cry. We all have so many emotions and like memories attached to the boys.
Liam Payne had been open about his struggles in the past. In an interview in 2021, he said he'd become very good at hiding it when he reached rock bottom. He was just 31 years old.
A man armed with a knife on the New South Wales Central Coast has died after being tasered by police. He was found with self-inflicted knife wounds on his body. The man in his 50s, who refused to cooperate with police, was treated at the scene but couldn't be revived. A critical incident investigation is now underway. It was the heroic action that cost an Australian man his life. Craig Laidley swept out to sea after helping save a drowning tourist in Bali. His family travelling to the holiday hotspot to help search for him, only to be told when they landed the devastating news. Amber Wilkinson with the details.
Craig Laidley's family had been praying for a miracle, trying to stay positive, but this morning the devastating news came. His body found on Secret Bay Beach, less than a kilometre from where he was last seen. The alarm was raised on Wednesday afternoon. Craig had been at a Balian beach on the island's northwest coast, about 30 kilometres from Denpasar. The 56-year-old spotting a swimmer in distress and rushing out to help. The German tourist managing to get out safely, Craig swept out to sea, sparking a massive search effort well into the night. Craig's two brothers travelling to Bali last night to help, but this morning the update no one wanted. His body spotted by staff at a nearby resort. Craig's family say they're extremely proud of his heroic efforts, now starting the process of trying to bring him home.
Today is World Menopause Day, and important and healthy conversations are underway to break the stigma around the symptoms. The main message this year, to take control. Davina Smith spoke with journalist Shelley Horton and advocate Claudia Jordan.
Menopause has been such a taboo topic, and yet I'm seeing it everywhere at the moment. We're talking.
Thank goodness, because you know what? It was secret women's business. Mm. My mum did not discuss it with me. Her generation just soldiered on. Gen X women are saying, no longer. We're going to talk about it. We're going to be advocating for our own health, and we're going to manage those symptoms.
And since you've started talking, what have you found?
Everyone has different forms of things that they're suffering with, yeah. And it's also you no longer feel alone. Yeah. So the biggest thing is don't be afraid to speak up, find a good GP, and know that there are treatments out there so you don't have to put up with the negative side effects.
And don't accept that this is just part of life.
That's right.
You can actually get treatment. Claudia, 80% of women between 40 and 64 suffer symptoms like hot flushes and mental health issues, we know that. But there are symptoms that are not as well known. Can you tell us a little bit about your story?
Well, I had endometriosis all my life, since I was 13. When I was 40, I had enough, so I had a hysterectomy. And now that I think about it, when I go back to about 45 years old, that's when I started experiencing vertigo. I was not a good sleeper, so insomnia, the roulette of different joint pains every morning.
Yeah.
And also, I've always been an hourglass. All of a sudden, my body just wanted to be a circle.
You're talking about things that are quite debilitating too. It affects every aspect of your life. Is that what you found?
Well, with me, it was because I worked from home. The only people that suffered were my family, because I didn't want to see my kids, I didn't want to see my husband, and this all happened during 2020. So we were all locked up together.
Yeah. What's life like now?
Oh, it's so much better. So there's no hot flushes. I'm sleeping a lot better. Like, I'm sleeping 7 hours. I was like unheard of. And I'm sure I'm a lot more pleasant to be around.
You're delightful to be around. Thank you for being here today, Shelley. I guess we've got lots of women and men watching at home right now.
Yeah.
What's your message to them? Because they don't have to suffer in silence.
Absolutely. I think this is where we need to take control and do some of your own research. Find a GP who listens to you. I had a horrible experience with my first GP who just wrote off all my symptoms as stress. And I think that there's a bit of gaslighting goes on there. Mm. So find someone who actually listens and takes you seriously, and know that there is help out there.